Hi, this is Riverside Studio VFX, and we're going to be doing a tutorial on compositing and Chroma keying in Blender, and here's the final result. Alright, so first we're going to open up Blender, and once we open up the starting scene, alright, so first we have to get the plates and the videos and images that we're going to be using. And this is where I got the video, which is the girl with the cape type thing. Alright, so this is the video I downloaded. It's free. And I'll put the website down in there. Alright, so this is the starting scene, and that's gonna be an image I'm gonna use. Alright, so first you need to go to Node Editor because we're not gonna be using anything in the 3D view. And alright, I need to open a new one. Okay, now we go to the Node Editor. And we need to click this one and click Use Nodes. Now this is the render layer, so we don't really need this, so just click on it and click X to delete it. And now hit Shift A to open up the Add menu, and then we're going to add an Output Viewer node. Yeah. Now Shift A again, and Input an Image. Okay, now open. I have to go find this video I put on my desktop. It's a whole bunch of images. So you just click and drag and import these images. All right, now you just click image sequence and drag this over, click on, drag that yellow dot onto the other yellow dots of the other ones. All right, so I think I messed up this part. All right, well, go back to where you got the images, click on the first one, the first image first, and then drag and drop, drag all, and pick all the other ones. Alright, now it's working. Okay, so now we're gonna go to image sequence and drag this all the way up. Alright, so now you can see that it's inside the, you can see it. Alright. Now you want to go down to Mate and Channel Key. This is so that we can get. Alright, now first we need to crop out the sides because you can't green screen those out. Alright. So now you want to pull this up to 1. And pull this up to 1. Oh, you have to click Relative, my bad. Alright. So now you want to drag it so that you can cut out this part. I think it was points. Alright, that's good. Alright, and then there's a little bit over here on the side, I think. Yeah, so you need to pull that over a little bit. There we go, that's good. Alright, so now you hit Shift A. And go into Mate and click Channel Key. And this is going to chroma key out the green. So make sure it's on max and the G for green. And just pull up the low to get rid of some of that green. And that looks pretty good. Alright, and there's going to be a little bit of color spill. So you want to pull up the color spill node and throw that in. You see it's kind of brownish, yucky color. Alright, so let's go to average. Pull up this one a little bit. And pull the matey over to the alpha. Alright, so that alpha, the bad background, but there's a little bit that's got cut out here, so pull down the low a little bit so we can get some more of that fabric. It's kind of hard because it's kind of transparent. Makes it a little bit difficult. You notice there's a little bit brown, but because of how we're making the scene, it will kind of look more stylistic rather than bad, I guess. Alright, so that's good. Now we're going to add the image that we're going to put on top. Alright, so now pick your image for the background. Shift A, color, and alpha over. And pull that and drop it onto the image thing. Alright, then drag this one over to here. Alright, well that's wrong. But alright, so you have to drag them the opposite way, my bad. Okay. And click on the non-alpha down here at the bottom, which is a checkered one. Okay, so now she's a little bit too big, and she's not. There's this railing down here, so I want to make her look better. All right, so click V to zoom out of that backdrop, which I clicked down here. All right. So now hit distort, scale up, to scale the girl up. And, just exit it out. Alright. Also, that's a little bit too big, so you need to pull it down with the scale to render size. Alright, so now I'm gonna drag these down over here, pull this over, so we get some more room to work. Take this off over, because we don't need that. Alright, we need another scale. Let's just drop it here. Scale this up to a relative 2 and 2. Okay, so now that's about the right size for me. Now I'm going to go to translate, to distort translate, and drag it onto here. And I'm going to pull this Y down a little bit so she's in the screen. And then I'm going to Alright, that looks good. There's a little bit of slot over here that looks bad. I'm just gonna drag it over a little bit. And that looks good. So that's pretty much it. Except, if you render now, you won't get anything. You'll get the beginning picture, because it's only connected to the viewer node, so you have to connect it to the compositor. The comp node, some people call it. And now, you want to mess with your dimensions over here and export it out as a QuickTime. So you can get a video. Now, render animation. And that's it. Thanks for watching. And I hope to upload more videos onto my channel soon.